Welcome to Star Stop. You're with me, Salil, and we've got the master and three new cubs, actually. Let's put it that way. Because it's going to be like that. So, is he daddy on the set? Is he not daddy? How are the other three that are going to be there? I'm going to introduce them all because it's always exciting when you see new talent coming out to the fore. When you see new talent which is just on screen, it's exciting. But when it's behind the screen and in front of the screen, they're going to be nervous. It's like the nervous 90s of the batsman. Avinash, Tripti, Sajid, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.
The three cubs, in case you all were confused. And like they say, the three musketeers and the fourth one that is ruling the roost. Imtiaz, sir, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to say this. Has it been a trying time to just make sure that your reputation, not just yours, everybody else's reputation is at stake, and that's how you have to pick up this entire project and put it together? Yes, once the release is done, they're on their own. But before them, before that day rather, you've got to use your name a lot. Is that a little different proposition for you?
It is a different proposition for me. But then I feel that something that I really want to do, which I feel is something that I'm proud to do, is something that I should take risks about.
Yeah.
Everything that you do, people will judge you. Yeah. And it is fine, you know. But sometimes you need to be judged for things that you are interested in doing. I really wanted this film to be directed by a new director because it's a very old story. Lots of us know fragments of this story. I wanted that it should have new people so that we can look at them and think we are looking at Laila and Majnu rather than at actors. And a new director who will at least surprise me, because I kind of knew what I would do with Laila Majnu. And I thought maybe the audience also has an inkling because I've done so many stories.
I think with you they do. There's a large portion of the audience that is fanatical about you. So a lot of directors have tried to get a fanatical fan following. You do have that. Hmm. You have that fanatical fan following with the actors, with the audiences. So it was, I think, a little bit of a risk also. I mean, yes, just the fact that he's your brother is a different zone. But putting a brand new director into something that you have conceptualized, screenplay, likha hai, sab kuch ye kara hai, so it must have been a little bit nervous for you also, na? No.
No, it not because my reputation was at stake.
Yeah.
It was the usual nervousness that you feel before going on stage, even if you remember your lines.
Yeah, yeah.
Or even if you know, you still feel nervous. So that kind of nervousness was there. And this whole thing that it better be good and try your best and all of that. But not because my reputation was at stake. Yeah.
No, I think, you know, as a filmmaker, if you had to worry about reputations, you wouldn't end up doing the kind of films that you do.
You'd probably not even end up doing films.
Yeah, because it's just there on one Friday and you see it so many times, you know. If you can diss, you know, big superstars, you know, and with just one Friday, suddenly you forget that Shah Rukh has given 20 years and suddenly you say, khatam ho gaya yaar, and oh, wapis aa gaya. You know, so this resurrection that happens in the minds of people is very different. Otherwise, films wouldn't be made. But the two of you, you've got Ekta Kapoor, you've got Imtiaz Ali, you've got this big banner that is coming up, you've got all this attention that's going to come to you.
Yeah.
I might not be a dream come true. I don't know what your dreams are yet, but unreal for you, right?
Of course, just see it
out there.
Yeah, we have been talking about this.
Yeah.
There's an Imtiaz Ali, there's a Balaji motion picture, Ekta Kapoor, a prolific filmmaker, there's this person who's ruling three mediums. I don't know if there's anyone in this industry.
No, she's genius, man. I have super respect for her.
What a spectrum.
Yeah.
And they've put their faith in us.
Yeah.
And we are representing that bandwidth.
When you go through the auditions, did you have to figure this out and say the enormity of the task? Because audition pass, I heard that you took a long time.
Yeah.
But then you got the whole film left after this.
Right.
Are you good enough to do the film? Is that in your mind?
Yeah, that was always the starting point, right?
Yeah.
When you get this opportunity, the story in itself is such a huge responsibility. Plus, it's your first film and you go through that feeling of, I want to really nail this. So there was a lot of nervousness at that point of time. Thankfully, now that we are done with the job, it's kind of relieved.
Yeah, now though you can of course sit and say, okay, they're enjoying it. Were you do you take time to break ice on set? You know, say with him, you know that you have to do, both of you getting launched. This is going to be the career for the both of you or not.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the brickbats are going to come both the ways or not. So it's like almost the first film for a brand new hero, heroine is always like very nerve-wracking. Yeah.
Yeah, man. I was very nervous initially.
Yeah.
In fact, I've been acting for 3 years and when I started off, I never thought that I would get an opportunity to work in a mainstream Bollywood film.
Yeah. Forget and about heroine. Doing,
as the main lead of the film. Forget about doing a film like Laila Majnu and that too with people like Imtiaz sir, Ekta ma'am and Sajid Ali. So yeah, I was nervous initially. There was a lot of pressure, but slowly.
But you know, so sometimes when you make transitions into films and all, a lot of people actually start to believe or question, do they belong in that medium? You know, sometimes I think advertisements and television is the safest medium, I feel, for actors. It keeps it going. You can make mistakes on Monday and by Thursday, you can rectify your mistakes.
That's true.
It doesn't really matter. You know, people have forgotten the episode on Monday. So I think film is a very different medium. You make a mistake, and if your director hasn't picked it up or has chosen to not see that, the audience will show you up immediately. Yeah. Slightly different zone there. Did you ever feel a sense of, do I belong here or not?
I still feel that.
Yeah.
In fact, I wanted to do TV. I remember in my school days, I used to tell my school friends, ki dekhna, one day I'll be the star of Colors channel. Yeah. I'll be up there.
You can still do that if you want.
I can, I have that option. But now I'm loving the space. I don't want to go back.
See, I like
that.
So that's initially it becomes, I'm going to do this if I can't do this. And then once this is doing well, we'll wait and see how this one does. And then we'll come to the television medium. But the man in question is going to have a lot of questions to answer, A, because of lineage and also because of your debut. That is you. But you look so calm, you look like a Buddha. Is that how you are all the time?
I'm laughing.
Do you do like the... Yeah, you look like a laughing Buddha. Are you like very calm, composed and collected all the time?
Not at all. That's my pretense.
Yeah.
I've become good at it.
Yeah? You're a hard taskmaster?
I don't think so.
What do you guys think? Of course you are.
Yeah?
Yeah, of course.
Only because you wanted the shot or because you were like... So, I, as a first-time director in a big mainstream film, and when you know that you have two young talents that are out there, nobody knows what they are, so you can mold them in a film as you choose. Do you tend to work a little extra or maybe try too hard? It does happen, you know, like in sport.
Yeah.
When your opposition isn't as great, sometimes you try to do a little too much and you get out in the process.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you think that happens? Did that happen to you?
I'm sure it must have happened many times.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. With these guys.
Yeah.
Because I tried, obviously I was like, we went through a long, huge process of this auditions.
Yeah.
And saw...
So what was it that you were looking for that you didn't find in this long process of auditions?
What I was looking for was so simple that it's just not available. Simplicity. Simple things are not available. I was just looking for a man, not a boy, a man, and a girl. Chote Sheher ki, small town girl. Just not getting it.
So do you think that Bombay has become a little too, how should I say this, paka hua? Everybody just knows what to do all the time.
I think that's the problem, because people who, the actors also who come for auditions, they are all, I wouldn't be able to tell the difference. Because they're all like cut in the same way. So many of them, not all, but...
No, but Imtiaz sir, won't you say this, that there was the Rajesh Khanna hangover, there was the Amitabh Bachchan hangover, then there was a Shah Rukh Khan hangover. I don't think there's an Aamir Khan hangover, because I don't think he sticks to a particular zone.
Right.
But I feel different kinds of films are being made now. Do actors still have hangovers of certain actors that they, especially when you see it, you know, you see so much of young talent wanting to come your way. Do you sometimes see that hangover still exists with a lot of actors?
I think actors have become smarter. They imbibe the good qualities. I've seen a lot of younger actors imbibe a lot of qualities, let's say from Ranbir.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
younger actors.
Yeah.
But they don't act like him.
Yeah, yeah.
They don't do that.
Okay.
So they get inspired by each other, and these guys also hang out together a lot.
Yeah.
But they don't do that, ki main bhi aise kar deta hun, Rajesh Khanna ki tarah. They don't do that.
It has changed now. I think with the audiences, it's become, because of the exposure, it's changed a lot.
Yeah.
This new world that we live in also. So if I come to you, you've got a lot of flack for your last film. Hmm. Were you taken aback by the extreme reaction? So, I mean, in recent times, say like a Race 3, okay, you like it or you don't like it. But the amount of trolling that it got online and on IMDb, it just reaches another, it becomes so personal. Yeah. It's like everybody went and they were so upset with Imtiaz Ali for not giving them what he had promised. Yaar, isko to main aur picture bana nahi dunga. Mere paise. So were you taken aback also by?
No, because I understand the business that I'm in. Yeah. We get a lot of attention. We get much more attention than we deserve, actually, being in the film business.
Right.
We also get a lot of intrusion. We also get a lot of, like, you know, people that are looking at you.
Yeah.
So, and I do know that these things have become, you know, it's not only completely organic anymore.
Absolutely, yeah.
Right? So there are many things, many agencies.
You can be targeted and
you can
all
be
kind
targeted.
Of things.
Yes. You can be targeted for a reason.
Yes.
I've seen this happening with various other films. I've seen it happening with my friends who are directors, etc. it didn't really surprise me. Because my whole thing is that film is permanent. Yeah. It has got such a long life that trends will change. Yeah. See, today, yesterday we were talking about Shahid Kareena having broken up and what impact it would have for Jab We Met. And we were so concerned and people had different views. But today, Jab We Met has obviously lasted longer than their reputation or their relationship, Similarly, all these things pass. I know that.
Like the Agnipaths of the world, if you go back in, didn't work then and now cult classics and all those kind of things. Here.
And there are so many films like that. Some of the, like Andaz Apna Apna, million times I watch it and laugh each time, was a flop. Sholay started off being... So the whole point is that films are permanent and that gives me a lot of consolation. Yeah. And after my work in a movie is done and the film is released, of course I would like to know what the genuine reaction is, but there's no way that it would affect me in a personal way.
The two of you working together, is that professional? Are you able to keep that professional or is...
Oh, it's very tough to keep it professional.
Yeah.
I think most mistakes happened on my part because I'm so used to him being the younger brother that I even on the set, couldn't, like the few times that I was there, it was difficult for me to keep a distance and maintain a certain dignity for him. I would.
I like that word. It's like, tu kar kyunki main bol raha hu na tere ko. So how did you maintain your dignity with Imtiaz? Let's put it that way.
I would, whenever he'd be around, I'd have to run. And,
but could you see your own vision? Because I've been reading a lot of what you said, or you know, you said it. You can't really call it my vision. That's what you say. It's him with my eyes also, but it's like it's all mixed up.
Yeah, it is. See, he actually gave me more dignity than I deserved. He gave me all the space and all the freedom, and he's been on the set a couple of times, but he never interfered. And I'll be always indebted. Also because this shows that he has confidence in me, so that really, you know, makes me good to go in the future. So I got a free hand. What was the other thing that you asked?
No, so when you were there, did you get?
Yeah, my eyes and vision.
Yeah.
Right. So it started off being his vision.
Yeah.
And I took. I think 2 to 3 years to just understand that vision.
So are you two sides of the same coin? A lot of people say you can't call it a co-direction, but when you all have written a story so closely, are you all both sides of the same coin or completely different?
Sometimes same, sometimes different.
Would you have shot it totally differently?
Absolutely, I think so. I think they're very different kind of elements, things that I had not expected that he came up with, even on the screenplay stage. The kind of characters that he had for Laila and Majnu, for instance, it is some completely his own doing. And also the characteristic of the scene, of many scenes, is very specific to the way he is thought of.
Of course. I mean, the style of an Imtiaz Ali will never be the same style of a Sajid Ali. And that's the beauty of it. Otherwise, you'd rather have Imtiaz directed. When you have, when you know that Imtiaz is like there, omnipresent, are your expectations of yourself as actors, were you all like thinking I should, were you all working extra in the night, extra in the morning, you know, or were you just letting it go? A lot of people say that I work very naturally also.
No, I don't think it was because Imtiaz sir is around that we need to put in extra effort. Like, I honestly feel he's been one guy who said, listen, I'll hold your hands and walk you through this journey of Laila Majnu. Yeah. You'll have to walk on your own feet though.
Yeah.
So, and that's what has happened. He's been a guiding force throughout, right from having our workshops together to...
Yeah, so I want to talk about that. Did you all do a lot of workshops together to get to know each other as well?
We did, I guess.
Yeah?
Ashley Lobo, he was working on our chemistry.
But that's movement.
Yeah.
We started off being very awkward when we started off.
Yeah?
Our first meeting was quite awkward.
So, all the workshops definitely did help.
Awkward because you all knew you had to be paired together, or awkward because generally that when you meet a person the first time, like when I meet somebody the first time, I'm not really awkward to them. What's up? I'll just go straight up.
I really don't know the reason for it. We met for the first time and we just didn't speak.
We were not talking. And
were you scared that they didn't speak? You were like, dude, is this going to work or not?
There was awkward silence in the room, and then he was like, to break the silence, he said, I think you guys should go out and talk to each other. Arranged marriages mein hota
hai. I think lunches or dinners bahut zaruri hote, but those movement workshops they're talking actually are very good in breaking the ice between the cast. It really works.
Yeah.
Was he like a daddy on set at all? Like, you know, jab naye log aate hain to thoda sa kid gloves ki zarurat padti hai starting mein.
Sajid?
Yeah. Oh,
he was like that with me for sure.
With you for sure?
You'd call him papa, na?
Really?
Yeah.
But so from the trailers, all I've seen is that lots of transitions in the characters.
Yeah.
It looks like a tough film physically also for you especially to do.
It was. We actually started shooting in the reverse order. So we shot the Majnu bit first, the hair and the beard and all of that. And then we came to the first part, where he's a little more flamboyant.
So
it was physically a little taxing for sure. You had to look a little weak in the first bit and then bring your charm out. I think...
But why did you shoot reverse? Straight away put them in the deep end so it becomes easier later on? Is that the thought process?
Just for beard and hair continuity, how can you achieve that? We wanted to not use a wig.
So the trick is that you have full-grown beard when you start and you keep snipping. So then you just go in reverse. That's the way. So because you can
always somebody has to keep beard continuity as well.
Yeah.
Wow, that's insane. Yeah. So why not use? I mean, you get really good prosthetics and these things, right?
No, it's not.
It's never
good.
Natural.
It's never as
like if you go to a very easy close-up, very intense close-up, you'll always see a fake beard. It's very tough. Or you smudge the entire face by doing corrections. Like you correct the beard, but then this starts looking bad, so you correct this, then finally it starts looking like a robot.
Did you think that this would happen, or do you think that keep laga denge chipka denge?
I think I'm glad that it happened like that. Yeah. So I could really be that person, try and be there.
Yeah.
Also, not only the beard, you also you start fasting and then you start eating well.
That also went in reverse order.
With the beard, yeah, all of that happened. So, yeah, it was a great process in itself. A very interesting way of shooting this film.
I think you get to live so many lives when you're being a character also. When you're shooting on the film, did you, were there some parts that you found a lot tougher to do, especially when you're shooting in Kashmir, it's nice and cold, wadiyan khoobsurat hai, but when you're in a shot, you're not admiring the beautiful landscape. You're more worried about getting the shot right.
I think for me, the entire first half of the film was a little difficult because Laila is very different in the first half than the second one.
Yeah.
And second half, Laila is more of me. I am very, I don't talk much. I'm very shy as a person. And Laila is totally opposite of that in the first half.
Okay.
So it was a little difficult to get into that.
So comfort zone, do you have like friends of yours? So when you're doing this film and all, suddenly all your friends know they can't talk about it maybe because it wasn't revealed earlier. So that zone, I know friends of mine who would sign big films, but for a year or so they couldn't talk. What are you doing? Something. Suddenly the changes are happening. Did you have to go through that?
I didn't tell my friends only.
Really?
Yeah.
So so when you had gone Gayab for how many months were you shooting?
3 months.
What did you say you were doing for 3 months?
Nothing. They didn't.
No selfies, no nothing at all?
No.
Wow.
They didn't text me only.
They didn't text you at all.
Good.
Dude, that's really great friends in 3 months. So now that the film is out there for everyone to sort of, you know, judge and be a part of, would you go back and do some things different?
No.
No?
Not yet. Not now.
You've seen the full product and that's how it stays with you?
Yeah.
You agree with his vision now? Or would you have inklings that you want to change?
No, I look at it like somebody else's film, honestly. And I really enjoy it.
So the first time you saw it, were you happy? Or
the
critical?
The first time I saw it were like just five scenes or rushes, actually. You're not really enjoying the film. And I was not happy at all. It was more like, why is this like that? Why is that like this? Why do you want to, have you shot it here? Why didn't you shoot it in the kitchen? And all that shit was going on.
Wow.
And because, you have to be critical about your own work.
Obviously,
that's a big disadvantage that somebody brings to the people he works with, because I will be critical about his work as well, you know, since we are working together. So I was like that. I was just seeing that, you know, the first time I see it, if there's anything that I need to correct, I must say it, because otherwise it'll have an impact for to the rest of the film. So I wasn't trying to be sweet at that point of time. But,
So was it a nerve-wracking time for you? Are you standing behind and saying, oh shit, am I going to have to reshoot all of it again?
Yes.
and did you?
That he's talking about.
Yeah.
When he saw the first cut of it, and it wasn't even my cut. I was seeing it with him for the first time.
Right.
So he just did not give me a chance to even
say anything.
Just blasted me throughout for I guess for an hour. He just kept hammering me. Then he said, okay, we'll look at it again. And then after he saw it again, he said, I didn't like it as bad as the
so
first.
So does that happen actually? When you see, a lot of people say, if you see something long enough, you can start to enjoy it as well. A lot of people don't like mannerisms when people first come out with it. I know, you know, with actors that happens. You don't like the way they speak, maybe you don't like the way they look, and suddenly in the fourth film, they say, bilkul perfect, and nothing has changed. Mm-hmm. And you go back and see that, sometimes it looks the same. Is that also because you start being less critical of it as filmmakers?
See, if something is good,
yeah,
but it is not according to your expectations,
yeah,
then you will not like it the first time, but mm-hmm. the second time you will be okay with it. Mm-hmm. Which is what happened with his scenes. It was, see, I'm a director. I don't claim to be anything else, honestly. Yeah. So if I read a script, if I write a script, I know how I'll be shooting it. I'm not a technical writer. I can't distance the vision from the words. So if I see you directing it, yeah. like in this case, I saw him directing it. I saw what he had done. It was different from what I would have done. That was almost like bad for me, right?
Brilliant. It's amazing how honest you can be about that.
Yeah, I thought it's not good. Then I blasted him because it was, he's like, you know, he enjoys that position of being blasted with me. And then I went down. I remember we had tea in the Tapri or something of that sort. We came back. I said, I have to see it again. Because I knew that something is wrong in my judgment also. I went and I saw the whole thing again. And I said, this time I didn't think it was too bad. Then I didn't say anything because I knew that I needed to actually give some time and watch it again. And then I realized it's different from my vision, from my direction, but it is not bad.
So Ekta's a very judgmental person also at times. She also knows exactly what she wants. So when she was watching it, were you getting another roasting there also?
No, thankfully not. That I wouldn't have survived.
I think she respects Imtiaz too much to be able to jump into that zone. I think you got lucky.
But the good thing about Ekta is that she's a very honest person as well. She'll say it.
Yeah.
But she and I have a relationship where we're not offensive to each other at all and can't be. So we could communicate easily.
So that respect level happened there. Hey, dude, if you shoot another film with them without Imtiaz around, it'll be a very different equation. The two of you, what's the most surprising thing about her that you found out on the set?
About her?
Yeah.
Surprising.
Now do you know like at the back of your hand or no?
No, now I do. Now I know. Right? Yes, of course.
So what surprised you most, even as an actress, you know, there was a zone.
I think what surprised me about her as a person was she didn't come across as someone who's so stubborn. You know, when you look at her.
She is?
I think that worked majorly for her as an actor because wo zid hai na, matlab, I want to do this.
So number one manne ki zid hai ya phir aisi stubborn?
No, just to get this right, the way I want it. And that was very interesting. I found that very exciting.
So it probably was irritating at first and became interesting later.
Yes.
Was it irritating?
I think it is still irritating.
And about him?
About him, I think he's someone who has an answer to every question. So I know for a fact that...
That's irritating.
It is quite irritating because he's always like, I know what you're talking about and I'll give you a better suggestion. And this is what you're talking. He knows everybody in the industry. He knows.
He does?
Yeah.
So he's...
We have met.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
So is he a gossip?
That's the last thing.
I don't know if I can say that.
Well, is he a gossip?
No, he's not.
No. One of his closest friends is the biggest gossip in the industry. Number one on the list of everyone. Mr. Ranbir Kapoor. And he doesn't even claim not to be. You know, he's there on every social website. He just doesn't want to say his own name there. But if you have worn a red pant tomorrow also, he'll say, I saw you in your red pant yesterday. But so he's like that. So is he Chupa Rustam gossip? No.
No. Chupa Rustam.
Yeah, y'all are very sidha. I think, sir.
Starting off.
Are they very sidha? Like totally dedicated students come to Shaolin Temple to just get the training. Aisa hai kya?
Absolutely.
Really? Yeah. So it worked out to be a dream then pretty much, right?
Absolutely. I'm still living it.
Yeah. So before we go, now that you've seen it, are you really proud of what you've done?
I will never be able to judge myself. I'm just happy that I survived this film.
Actually, I guess the first film around. Yeah. We'll speak to you about a year later if you want any changes. You're pretty proud of what he's done?
I'm very proud of the film.
Yeah.
I am very proud of the film. The last time he showed it to me, the entire cut with everything, I thought if there was a way of saying proudly presents, it would be even better.
That's fantastic. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you so much.
Good luck.
Thank you so much.
And you're too far away, but I'll say it. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
We'll see you all soon. And till the next time, take care. And remember, all these interviews, always up on the digital website, B4U Entertainment. You can go check it out. It comes out on the day of the release. So if it's out on a Friday, this is going to be out on the Friday morning. That's it, right? So we've done it a lot earlier. But on the day of the release, it'll be out. Take care. Bye-bye.